moving the ball. Excellent teamwork. Shot clock down to six. Converts on the inside.
The ball movement in this game has been phenomenal, forcing a lot of defensive rotations and ultimately a lot of passes leading to direct scores.
It's good. A two-pointer. The Bucks up by eight.
You need guys who can make shots under duress and pressure. That was a well-defended possession, but that man stuck it even against the best defense.
Team. For two. Shot won't go.
Poise and precision will get you a better quality shot than that. That's a bailout shot.
Oh, that was sweet.
With the jam. The assist from
nice ball movement. Griffin finding all the room. He shoots. And he draws the foul.
That's his
and he'll head to the line
foul
for the fourth time
the
tonight.
Outstanding performance by this excellent player, particularly tonight from the free throw line, where he has yet to miss.
First free throw, perfect.
Stepping in for the Atlanta Hawks, number four, Aaron Aflalo. Stepping in for
good free throw shooting, comes down a pair. To a swallow. Quick feedback
left in the first quarter.
Horford has the double team converged. Two-pointer won't go.
The double team came hard and high and to the post player's body. That's what forced the difficult shot attempt and the miss.
For the Milwaukee
and he'll head to the line with under two to go here in the first.
To the line for two.
And he connects on the first free throw.
Into the game for the Hawks. Number eight, Rudy Gay.
Goes two for two at the line. To a swallow. Gay on the drive for the layup. Free throw's coming up. He got hit in the act of shooting.
Hey, you don't see strength like that very often. The way he got fouled, just to get the ball up and to the rim, was a great achievement.
And he hits the first free throw.
Entering the game for the Bucks, number 25.
Player shuffling going on here.
Subbing in for the Hawks, number 31, John Hansen.
Moving the ball around beautifully. Rose. Nice move into the paint. With the ball in possession. Oh, rejected. Terrific rejection.
And I can see how things might start to get a little chippy. Lots of contact, but a lot of blocked shots here in the first half by both teams.
And number 25.
The two defenders swarm. And he curls in. Oh, that's a get out of my way. I'm throwing it down.
Oh, he just stole his heart with that dunk right there.
They double him. Making the defense work with excellent ball movement. Tied up and has to pass. It's blocked. Griffin's denied. stand up, has to make that pass. He curls, puts it down.
First half, they've made a conscious effort to move the basketball around and get quality shots.
Aaron to follow. A nice look from downtown.
Man, he got that one off quick.
Number 25.
The Bucks with the ball here. His jump shot won't go.
You defend, you always have a chance to come back and win a game.
4-2.
4 minutes gone by in the second. Milwaukee up by 13.
Rose.
Screen set nicely. Slams it home for two.
If that's the best he can do as a defender, then he has to come out and sit next to me as the coach. You've got to keep the ball handler out on the perimeter and make him take jump shots.
Looking to curl in. Double team swats that away.
And before we've even reached halftime, we're seeing block shot totals that would be the envy of any coaching team in this league.
Schroeder set to bring it up. Ball knocked loose. Reaches in for the steal. And he throws it down.
Oh, that's nice right there. The finish at the rim with a nice dunk.
Two defenders. Shot is blocked. Out of bounds. Atlanta's making a few subs here. There's the double team. Myers for three from the corner. Won't go. This is his first field goal attempt of the night. Blocked by Carroll. Look at him leave his feet for the ball. Out of bounds. Turnover. Here's the pick. Griffin shot. Turn back. Ball goes out of bounds. It'll be Bucks ball.
You're down in a game and you make one of those turnovers, it's absolutely crushing in trying to complete a comeback.
To the basket, flips it up, whistle blows, it's a foul. Al Horford picks up his first foul of the night, and he'll head to the line for the sixth time tonight. Boy, this guy has got it rolling from the free throw line tonight. Hasn't missed one yet.
And gets both points from the line. Number 8, Rudy Gay.
The Hawks bringing the ball up. Horford, good touch inside.
What a job they have done keeping the ball moving to the open man and creating scoring opportunities for each other.
Excellent ball movement. Great teamwork. They're all over him. Still puts it up. Misses that one. There's the perfect kick. comes off the screen to the basket. There's the whistle. Good job to draw the foul. And he'll head to the line for the seventh time tonight. First free throw, good.
Number 34, shooting two.
Able to convert on both free throws. The two defenders swarm. Warford converts on the inside.
Look at that release of that layup. Up and over the outstretched hand and the shot line. Beautiful touch.
To the basket. An easy layup and it won't go.
It's hard to pass the ball out of a great double team because you come to their body where they have no room to pivot or create space to throw the ball out of the low post.
The Hawks with the ball in control. Teague looking to dupe the defense, draws the double team off the mark. They double him inside, score the goal and one. And he'll head to the line with a chance to complete a three-point play.
That's great athleticism right there to finish with strength, absorb the contact, and earn your way to the line.
Long range pass. Double team closing in. Right back. To Horford. Two defenders, and he gets the shot off. Can't get it to fall. Strong finish at the rim.
Hey, you're not a one-man team. You've got to spread the ball around so that you can get better shots than that. A coach cannot stand for those type of shots.
Oh, that's a devastating dunk in his face.
And there's no doubt we'll be seeing that one on Sports.
Showing off the handle here. Double team still puts it up. Hayes unable to knock it down. Pass intercepted by T. Fires away for two. Soft touch gets the roll.
I love when teams share the ball. You learn everything you needed to know in this world in kindergarten. And the number one thing that Mrs. French taught me was share. And I'll tell you what, they are sharing the basketball here today.
Oh, and he throws it down. Queued up and ready to go. Here's that play one more time.
The best way to make a comeback in the NBA, wide open threes, layups, dunks, free throws. You do that by getting the ball at the basket.
2 points. The assist from number 26.
Today, with no room to shoot, knocks it down, a two-pointer. And Al Horford with 8 points in the second quarter.
And this is what basketball is all about. Who wouldn't love the way this team has been moving? Sharing the ball.
Personal foul. Team foul number 4. Atlanta Hawks.
Knocks down the first one.
Into the game for the Milwaukee.
And he makes the ball.
Number 12. Jabari Parker. Subbing in for Atlanta. Number 25.
Atlanta's bringing the ball up. Terrific ball movement. Fires from three-point range.
Rudy,
that's good. Atlanta's 3 for 5 from the outside.
The assist from...
And when will it stop? These guys are shooting three-pointers like they're layups.
2 minutes remaining in the second
beats his
quarter.
Man. Double team, able to get the shot off.
The assist.
Horford. He shoots. Two-pointer won't go. Here's the screen. Forced to make the pass. The two defenders converge. No doubt about it. He hit him. It's called against Teague. And he'll head to the line with under a minute and a half to go in the first half.
Really good performance from the free throw line tonight, where he's 100%.
First free throw, perfect.
Oh, that was great body control to be able to absorb the contact and still get off a quality shot. Just didn't get it to drop.
Number five, Michael Carter-Williams.
And that's his fifth rebound of the game. Teague against Rose. To Gay. Smothering defense, and he gets the shot off. And Jabari Parker with an excellent challenge, forcing the miss.
Poise and precision will get you a better quality shot than that.
1 minute.
That's a bailout shot. That's a, I'm going to try to get us back in and be a hero type of shot.
The Hawks with the ball in possession. Reaches in. It's stolen. The Bucks with the ball here. Throws it down.
Home or away. That'll excite NBA fans. The dunk.
Number five, Michael Williams.
Teague draws the double. Moving the ball. Excellent teamwork. Throws it down early.
Nice dunk. Nice strong finish at the rim.
The assist from number 25.
There's the double team. Terrific block by Horford. Shut down, forced to make the pass. Griffin fires, gets it to go. Long two-pointer.
The assist from number 7.
They haven't played well up to this point. This basket, if they can score, will give them some momentum.
And Milwaukee's called for their first team foul. And Al Horford will go to the line with seconds to go here in the first half. And he connects on the first free throw. Strong rebound. Excellent position by Parker. Griffin follows with the fourth shot. That's it for the first half. Milwaukee up by 21. Stay tuned for more Sunday Night NBA present. Welcome back to Phillips Arena for the second half. Along with Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Breen on hand. Milwaukee's in one of those zones halftime here, and they are up huge. Can they play any better?
Just mesmerizing offensive basketball. Sharing it, running the floor, running hard, execution. That was just beautiful basketball to watch.
The Hawks with the ball in control. Nice ball movement for two. Unable to flip it in.
This team doesn't have enough offensive talent to miss the makeable shot. They've got a
Griffin shot blocked.
Man, we used to have a block party at 612 Blue Ridge Drive, but I haven't seen a block party like this since then.
Teague off the mark from three-point land. Rose bringing it up. And he throws it down.
Hey, can you say blowout? Is it going to change? Not with this defense. This defense is the reason why they cannot compete here tonight.
Moving the ball around beautifully. Tied up and has to pass. Misfires. Horford shot swatted away. To Rose.
making the baseline move. The two defenders swarm. Good touch inside.
Solid fundamental layup, but look at the explosive athleticism to drive up to the basket.
Gets past the defender. Deeks turned away. What a try to keep the ball in bounds.
Hey, sometimes you don't get your clock shots early. Sometimes the offense, give them credit. They're going to shoot the ball early. They're going to pass it as you come to help. But what he's done is continued to make plays defensively here in the second half, blocking shot after shot.
Playing inside out. Looks to put it back up again. Can't get it to go down. Tied up. Has to make that pass. Horford has the double team close in. That's a two. Atlanta down by 26. Horford. And now it's one free throw to finish off a three-point play.
It's been this way the whole night. Easy basket. Here another example. A dunk, a foul, a possible three-point play. Over and over again, we've seen the same mistake. Bad defense, soft fouls.
Able to convert the free throw, and he completes the three-point play. Atlanta's bringing the ball up to Gay. Looks to the post. Horford fires away. Boy, is he in the zone.
The assist from number 8, Rudy Gay.
And the paint. Draws the contact. Yep, it's a foul called against Teague. Milwaukee shooting 95% from the line in tonight's game.
Number 34, shooting two.
And he hits the first free throw. Good free throw shooting, knocks down a pair. Teague against Rose. Forced to make the pass. Can't get it to go. They double him to the rim. Nice job drawing the foul. It's called against Gay. And back to the free throw line for two more free throws.
Foul number 3 for the Bucks. Number 3
free throw
to the line, shooting 2. Stepping in.
Goes 2 for 2 at the line.
Number 5, Michael Carter Williams.
The Hawks bringing the ball up. Goes to the goal. Converts on the inside.
Well, that's George Gervin like right there. Contort your body, get it up and over the top of the shot clock.
To the rim. Good touch inside. That's a 16-6 run for the Bucks. The Hawks with the ball in possession. Making the defense work with excellent ball movement. Converts on the inside.
Outstanding body control and then the ability to still finish and concentrate. I'm sometimes mesmerized by what these athletes can do.
Dumps it off beautifully. Curling in. Oh, excellent screen. Curls in. Carter Williams jump shot. Misses that one.
You never know in this league. You just work for 48 minutes. Challenge shots. Make it hard on the other team. You can get back in the game.
What a rejection.
And when it comes down to shot blocking, it has not been a one-sided affair. Each of these teams has done a tremendous job of redirecting shots.
Off the follow, good touch inside.
2 points.
Double team closing in. The screen is set. Moves around the defender. Gets in the paint. He got a piece of it. Whistle sounds. Out of bounds. So it'll be Bucks ball. Mike Budenholzer makes a few substitutions. And he curls in. They don't beat the buzzer. A shot clock violation for the Bucks.
No basket.
Ball's in. Schroeder against Carter Williams. Excellent ball movement. Great teamwork. Schroeder. He curls off the screen with the layup. And Milwaukee's called for the foul. Their first team foul. Atlanta's 4-for-7 from the line tonight.
Team foul number one.
Knocks down the first.
The Atlanta Hawks. Number one to the line.
And gets both points from the line. The Bucks with the ball here. The two defenders convert. Converts on the inside.
I like that he didn't go for style points. Just nice, easy layup at the basket.
Horford's trying to get down low. There's the double team. A follow. Finds room off the screen for the shot. The Bucks with the ball. Control. The two defenders swarm. Terrific ball movement. Nice catch and shoot. Touch there, not this time.
Listen, they're down big in the second half. Anybody can give in right now. I like to see players who are willing to play the full 48 minutes and contest shots just like that.
Gets it off. That's a two-pointer. Off target. They double him, looking to curl in. All the way. Count it. Plus the foul. It's on to the free throw line. One shot to complete the three-point play.
That's great athleticism right there to finish with strength, absorb the contact, and earn your way to the line.
Moving the ball. Excellent. Oh, rejected. Nice display of extra hustle.
Great bounce back second half as far as shot blocking is concerned. Didn't get off to a great start, but here in the second half has protected his rim with ferocity.
Double team closing in, gets to the rim, not able to score.
Hey, they got lucky right there. They gave him a good look right at the rim and were just fortunate that the ball didn't go down.
Shut down, forced to make the pass. Bang! Milwaukee shooting 45% from downtown tonight.
Hey, you play defense like this, you deserve to lose. You deserve to get blown out, and that's what's happened here tonight.
A follow. And now he moves around the defender. Won't go.
If you don't screen any better than that, you're not going to get a quality shot. You want to get open? Set a great screen, and you will be open. Here, a contested shot shows that the screen
counted and the foul. And he'll head to the line with a chance to complete a three-point play.
I love it when I see a guy concentrate through contact. He did, getting the ball in the basket and drawing the foul.
Ball knocked out of his hands. Shoots for three. Won't go from outside the arc. Back come the Bucks. The two defenders converge. Parker from downtown. This fires from long distance.
Hey, you could sugarcoat it, but this is a disappointing effort. One good challenge doesn't cover up the multitude of defensive sins that have gone into this game.
Carter Williams. Up and has to pass. Parker jump shot. And that won't go. A follow brings it across. Wide open for two. The Hawks with the offensive rebound and keep it alive. Good touch inside.
Great concentration. And finish on that layup. Beautiful, beautiful play.
Nice ball movement. At the rim, Horford the rebound. Schroeder to the rim. Dennis Schroeder with a nice look.
The assist from number 17.
There's the double team. Dennis Griffin. Griffin blows the whistle. He's got a foul.
To number five.
And he gets to go back to the free throw line. Couple of more free throws.
Number 34 to the line, shooting two.
First free throw, perfect.
Stepping in for the Hawks, number 31, John Hansen. Into the game for the Bucks, number 26.
Able to convert on both free throws. Two and a half remaining in the third. The Bucks up by 30. Two. Curling in. A follow from downtown. Strong offensive rebound. Misses the two. The two defenders swarm. Passes it back to him. Puts it up. Converts on the inside.
That's just a nice layup right there.
2 minutes left in the third quarter.
The Hawks with the ball in possession. Moving the ball around beautifully. Horford's looking to do damage in the paint. Three-point attempt. Can't hit from beyond the arc. Adjusts. It's good. And one. And he'll go to the line for the first time tonight, looking to finish the three-point play.
That's the concentration you need to finish with contact and earn your way to the free throw line.
Whoops, that won't go. The Bucks with the ball here. Curls in. They double him. Feeds it right back. Griffin able to connect. Gorgeous feed.
The assist from number 26.
Pretty pass. Schroeder moves around with it. Oh, nice block. Goes to the reverse. Good touch inside.
Sometimes the simplest play are the hardest ones to execute. Good lay.
1 minute remaining in the third quarter.
Double team closing in for the layup. Michael Carter Williams with his third assist of the night.
Look, you can't give up layups like that. You got to protect the basket and the paint at all costs.
Schroeder against Carter Williams. Making the defense work with excellent ball movement. With plenty of room, he fires for two. Can't connect.
That's good offense. Wide open jump shots are what you're trying to create. They created one. Unfortunately, they're missing here tonight, and they missed another wide open look.
Concrete's unable to hit the three.
This defense is an absolute joke. But what's worse,
and that's it. Time runs out. The final score is 147-112. For Jeff Van Gundy and our entire EA Sports crew, this is Mike Breen saying thanks for watching and good night.
Here we go with the EA Sports post-game wrap-up. The Bucks put together a nice win here today. The scoring display they put on is gonna be hard to forget. It's hard to imagine anyone doesn't come away impressed with how effectively they score their points. What you see here is how the majority of the points were scored for the Milwaukee Bucks. The Hawks suffered from a lacking offense in this contest. So it's imperative that they put this one behind them and start preparing for the next matchup. Check out the leading scores for the Atlanta Hawks.
Game status. The game.
I like this choice because he really put on the show in this game. There's a reason he's a fan favorite. And here we have a look at his stat line. Here are the latest scores from around the league. Here are the upcoming games. On behalf of ESPN on EA Sports, I'm Jalen Rose, and it's been our pleasure to present you with some NBA basketball.
NBA Live 15. Mick.
What's up, everybody? I'm Rocky, NBA Live designer with ESPN basketball analyst Jalen Rose. So, Jalen, among all the NBA teams that made the playoffs this year, which one is least likely to make it to the postseason next year?
You have to start out west. Just think about it like this. The last game of the regular season, a game at New Orleans, was the difference between the defending champion San Antonio Spurs being a number two seed or a number six seed, which helped propel the Houston Rockets, who ended up getting the second seed, into the Western Conference Finals. So it definitely has to be a team out west. And so I look at the Dallas Mavericks. You bring in Rajon Rondo, it doesn't work. Chandler Parsons, he was injured through the playoffs. You hope to get him back healthy. Dirk is going to be a year older, as well as Tyson Chandler. It's really important for Mark Cuban, their owner, to get a splash, a big-time player, an all-star caliber player in free agency.
See, my pitch has been perfect of lately. I curve conversation, ain't wasting a vocal, just pay me.